Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this podcast, we are going to look into arum triphyllum according to Allen's keynotes. So let's get started. Arum triphyllum is commonly called as Indian turnip and it belongs to the family Araceae. The spelling is A-R-A-C-E-A-E, Araceae. I don't know the exact pronunciation, but I guess I pronounced it the way I learned. So the coming to the generalities, the patients pick and bore into the raw bleeding surfaces, though they are very painful and scream with pain, but they keep up the boring. And so yeah, that kind of irritation is constantly seen, and in patients who constantly pick and have their nose almost every time in their nostrils, and that is commonly seen in small children. So in that cases we can think of arum triphyllum. And desquamation in large flakes a second or third time in scarlatina. I guess there is a desquamation, that means the picking of the nose or say dry scabs in the nostrils. There is desquamation, or the internal mucosal membrane gets up easily, and there is desquamation, and a second or third time in scarlatina. I guess I should go through that sentence again. And the typhoid scarlatina with apathy, scanty or suppressed urine and threatened uremia. So in typhoid fever, there is indifference, that is apathy, or scanty or suppressed urine, wherein there is urine suppression is seen, and there is threatened uremia. As there is suppression of urine, there is increased urea or uric acid which are excreted through the urine, and these levels go up inside the blood, and there may be threatened uremia. These things are very much uncommon nowadays. So the common presentation can be constant picking or boring thing in the nose. And coming to the respiratory system, there is coryza, which is acrid and fluent, and the nostrils are very much raw. Nose feels stopped up in spite of the watery discharge. So this is a very important and peculiar symptom. Though there is a coryza, or say flowing of the watery discharge from the nostrils, they feel always there is a stuffed up feeling in the nose. And the sneezing, which is aggravation at night, so that is a very, very important symptoms. Generally we tend to listen to patients say that they have this increased sneezing specifically in the morning after they wake up, but in here arum triphyllum the sneezings are worse during night. And there is acrid ichorous discharge, that is burning discharge, or it's a blood tinged watery discharge, so there may be blood tinge as well. Excoriating inside of nose alley and upper lip, so which is like very, very burning in nature, and very much acridity is seen. Constant picking at the nose until it bleeds, boring with the finger into the side of the nose. So there is constant kind of irritation inside the nostrils which compels the patient to constantly pick the nose. Pick lips until they bleed. Corners of the mouth are sore. They crack and they bleed with the tendency of malignancy, or say with malignant tendency. We can see that in condyrrhango, the cracked corners of the lips, and they bite nails until fingers bleed. So these people are very much fond of bleeding, I guess, because they bleed, they pick up their nostrils and lips until they bleed, and also they bite their nails until they bleed. And there is aphonia complete after exposure to northwest winds or from singing, for after excessive usage, or say cold air exposure. And clergyman sore throat, voice hoarse, uncertain, uncontrollable, and which changes continually, worse from talking, speaking or singing. Orators, singers and actors. So not only nostril symptoms, or say symptoms related to coryza, throat symptoms are also very important. Specifically, there is a change in the throat which continuously changes, and a sore kind of throat. The sore mouth and nose are guiding in malignant scarlatina and diphtheria. So also these are very rare, because diphtheria, there is a preventive vaccine which is very much common in the immunization schedule. So it's very rare we find these kinds of cases. And stomach and abdomen, children refuse to food and drink on account of soreness of mouth and throat, and are sleepless. So there is excessive soreness, or say we can imagine if we just think over the worst kind of cold when we had, that sensation I can just feel during the narration as well. So there is excessive soreness of nose and throat, and they doesn't want to eat anything, because even that swallowing is much painful. And the saliva is profuse, acrid, and it also corrodes the mucous membrane. Tongue and buccal cavity are raw and bleeding. So there is excessive rawness and bleeding situation in nostrils, mouth, swelling, you know, mucous membranes are all swollen like that. And relation, it is useful after Heparin Sulf and nitric acid in dry, hoarse, croupy cough. After causticum and Heparin Sulf in morning, hoarseness and deafness and scarlatina. Should not be given low or repeated often, as bad effects often follow. So it shouldn't be given too low or should it be repeated as well. The higher potencies are most prompt and effective. So yeah, that's all about Arum Triphyllum according to Allen's keynotes. So if you like this podcast, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and do check out my another channel wherein I'll be sharing very lesser known facts about mind, health, lifestyle, weight loss, food, etc. So yeah, that's all for this podcast. Bye bye. Have a great day.